This is a five contender scramble match. First fall to a finish will not only win the match, but they will be the number one contender for the RWA Triple Crown Championship. Your referee for this bout, Mr. Mac Madness.
Cash, you want to talk about somebody who's impressive everywhere he goes, looking for an opportunity and a shot at the Triple Crown Championship, just like all the competitors in the RWA signature match, the El Dirtay. Marchand, nothing but impressive in almost every altercation I have ever seen him in, which absolutely earns him a spot in tonight's El Dirtay. But you want to talk about heavy competition that he has tonight between Shay Cash and the remaining wrestlers in this field. He has got an uphill climb ahead of him. Talk about the fan favorite, the one man in this contest who holds, in my opinion, the rights to the number one contender spot for the Triple Crown Championship, but yet the RWA officials have said that his victory at the Thanksgiving throwdown is now null and void, and now he must earn his shot again. Somebody who's really been tearing it up in every place he has been. Just last night earned himself a potential shot at a future NCW Heavyweight Championship with a win at the Oxbaker Cup, and now he hopes to win a shot at the Triple Crown, but not if the Prince has anything to do with it. The last Watch This Fight champion. He is now the current junior heavyweight champion of New England, and he currently holds the Proving Ground Heavyweight Championship AJP is looking to collect another championship belt to his collection with the RWA Triple Crown, and all roads go through the El Dirtay.
This is quite the windy road to be on, but each of these contenders have proven their value, have proven their worth, and have proven that they are just as tough and durable as one may need to be to survive such a matchup.
No doubt whatsoever. Durable would explain each and every one of these wrestlers, talented in their own rights, different styles, and you know, styles make fights.
Absolutely, and styles certainly account for a lot of viewership, but let's face it, Simon Eddie, in my opinion, the factor that weighs in the heaviest would have to be stamina. You can have all the style in the world, but if you cannot go the distance, you're not necessarily going to be slated as a champion.
And if stamina was the only thing we were judging on, I would tell you right now, I'm going with Ricky Medieros. Absolutely.
That's a little tough to argue considering how many wars Dick Lane has been in, but Ricky Medieros certainly does have a gas tank unlike anyone else on the roster. He's not the most technical, but for a guy his size, he brings intensity.
He's got greasy, fast speed. Rock.
Always room for Mickey impressions at the commentary booth.
But don't forget, I did say, if stamina was the only thing we judged on, there are so many other factors, especially in an environment like the El Dirtay. And I was just saying that Nick Marchand has been impressive in almost every altercation I've ever seen him in, but now he's on the floor.
He can't help but have the spotlight on himself. And, you know, there he was making this match as typical about himself, and he just bit off a little bit more than he could chew. Everybody here is fighting for the same chance to be champion, the same number one contendership. That is not to be taken lightly.
Dick takes a dive to the outside as we look for the first cutter. Wait a second. Hooks him up. Ricky Medieros up in a bad position. Hurricane run, and out goes Shay Cash. Super kick low. Ricky Medieros looking for some air. That front row is in serious danger.
And Ricky Medieros is ever so impressive to be able to dive the way he does it. He always sticks the landing. He makes it look so flippin' easy.
An emphasis on flipping, but it looks like the Prince. Oh, the Prince got taken out with a knee lift to the face.
Nick Marchand saw the opening. He saw the opportunity. He's not taking it. Go for that pin. Cover here. Remember, folks, this is not an elimination-style matchup. The first person to complete themselves a three-second pin or execute a submission will be the winner.
It's not what I'm familiar with in my home, but that's exactly what they're dealing with here. You want to talk about adding risk for the reward. There is no just letting someone get eliminated. No, it's one fall to a finish, all five men.
Nick Marchand now in the driver's seat. He has got himself a very good rhythm. Seems to be in control.
Control of AJP, the number one young gun. And Marchand is absolutely trying to control the field, keeping the rest of the competitors out on the floor.
Sound strategy, if you ask me. You know, this kid's ego is usually his biggest enemy. If he could stay focused to the task at hand, I grant you, you're going to see more of him in a title picture as time goes on.
Wait a minute. AJP firing back with a knee lift. Takes the legs out from under Marchand. Oh, and a kick to the face.
And you got to wonder, like, did the boss possibly put him in this matchup to play spoiler against Marchand, considering how he could keep up with him? He's got the same kind of speed.
Yeah, you know what? I can't disagree with that. But the fact of the matter is this. The man's no slouch. He's currently the Proving Ground heavyweight champion. He's currently the New England junior heavyweight champion. He was the last Watch This Fight champion. He is no slouch. And we just got a broken hand out on the corner.
That's a hasty decision. Ricky Medieros looking to do a little bit of extra damage on a Dick Lane, and it cost him. Shay Cash folding AJP inside out and through the ropes.
And that's why I respect your point, but I got to say, I don't think T. Phoenix would intentionally put his son in that kind of danger against someone like Shay Cash.
Well, unless he had the vote of confidence that he could survive it. I mean, this young man is basically grown up in the wrestling ring, but You know, all the experience of the world is not going to be able to amount to just size and mass, and that's what Shay Cash is bringing to this matchup.
And you know what? If stamina was the only deciding factor like we discussed earlier, maybe Shay Cash ain't the guy. But the fact is, any guy can run circles around him. If he catches you once, that could be the end of your night. This crowd solidly behind Dick Lane with a stomp to the foot and a little bit of that Japanese anime flair. Dick Lane needs to take this seriously. Looking for a spin out kick to the back of the head. Looking for a combination. Hooks him. Flatliner.
Dick Lane is firing on all cylinders. Oh, a little early on that back body drop attempt, and it costs him. Medieros
going for a cutter, and he gets it.
Dick Lane to his feet really quick, but the lights are not all on it. Cutter Kowalski!
But Dick Lane is still finding his way back to his feet, reverses the Irish whip, ducks under the clothesline, back spring off the ropes, and a cutter! Oh, and a big drop kick from Nick Marchand.
One of the fiercest drop kicks you will find on the RWA roster. All the wind has been taken out of Ricky Medeiros' sails with that one shot.
Nick Marchand is so calculated, and look at this. He's trying to clear the ring of everybody but Dick Lane at this point, who just took three consecutive cutters from Ricky Medeiros.
You know, Medeiros had himself a big win over Devin Baker last month. He has grown as a performer. You know, he has certainly come into his own as a singles competitor. He's not that second fiddle player anymore.
And you also got to think about Nick Marchand. Nick Marchand gets this opportunity to become the number one contender to the RWA Triple Crown Championship. But you got to remember, the last time we saw him, we were supposed to see him against Mike Montero. Now, unfortunately, situations, you know, cards subject to change as always, and he wound up in there with John Steele. He was no less impressive, but a victory against John Steele does not move you up the cards like a victory over Montero would have.
Absolutely. He knows this. He's bitter about it. You can see him taking out all that aggression on his constituents, if you will. Oh! Dick Lane has just severely planted the showman. That was intense. He's going to have some damage. There's some serious brain damage right there. I don't care.
Dick Lane, not necessarily known for the top rope game, and he appears to be going up top, but Ricky Medeiros cuts him off at the pass.
And certainly in the high-risk district right now, things are starting to get a little clustered, if you will.
Wait a second. AJP now up in the scuffle. No. Nick Marchand. Those ropes. Oh, God. If Shay Cash decides to climb on those ropes, the night's over for everybody. Oh, wait a second. That's the smart money. Dangerous! I believe that was a hell of a tower, and I believe Dick Lane just landed on the face of AJP.
Well, the Leaning Tower of Riverside has tumbled into the ring. The only man standing at Shay Cash, and right now, if he could time things, he could potentially be the number one contender for the Triple Crown.
He's already been the hype champion. He's already been a tag team champion, looking for that Triple Crown, but Dick Lane looking for a Saito suplex. I'm genuinely concerned. Oh, Jesus, blue thunder bomb! I am genuinely concerned for the health and well-being of AJP. That was not a good, oh, Jesus, kid, stay down. Ricky Medeiros coming to fight off Shay Cash. Shay Cash stands alone like Godzilla amongst many destroyed buildings. Oh, you know, this is not good.
A lot of people forget that Shay Cash is a former hype champion. Right now, he's got his sights set on the biggest and baddest prize in the RWA.
AJP running on pure instinct at this point. Ricky Medeiros with another cutter. If I were that kid, I'd roll out to the floor and live to fight another day. But I also know he's not going to give up an opportunity at the Triple Crown Championship. Nick Marchand back in control. Misses a knee directly to the second turnbuckle.
To
Dick Lane blocks the punch. Big kick in the face. Dick Lane going back to the top rope for whatever it is he was going for. Wait a second. Could we see it? He's going for the anti-life equation right on the head of Nick Marchand. Cover. Yeah. Say what you want about Dick Lane. Say what you want about the fact that he may have lost or had his championship opportunity expire. But Dick Lane, this is a fixed point in time, Bobby Rossi, because no matter what happens tonight in your main event, no matter what happens next, Dick Lane is the next man in line for the RWA Triple Crown Championship. Little Doctor Who in there. Fixed point in time.